Alright. Couple minutes late, getting details done. I hope only a couple minutes late. We're gonna make sure everything's going. Oh man. This is gonna be interesting. So. Yep, we're live. We're rocking. We'll send out a tweet and a, thing in a minute right here to tell people that we're live both on Facebook and on Twitter. But for now, hey, welcome to Comicovnos. This is our, premiere episode. Sorry if I'm going to take a second to get things rolling. I'm going to be looking at my notes a little bit, try to keep reflections and stuff out. We got all the equipment rigged. If everyone can hear me. Yep, everything's good. Cool. Sorry, pounding on the mic. Probably have no viewers unless I got my one homie. So let's get going. My name is Alejandro Santisteban, also Axel Grave, for those who know me well. And I want to welcome you to the first episode of Comicovnos, which is a new podcast that's supposed to be hosted by me and a friend, Leo Rydel, also at hashtag The Blurred. Doing his thing over there, blogging and writing for different websites, which mad props to him, dude, doing what he loves for a living. But we're coming in on this very, very first episode. It's December 22nd, 2016, for posterity's sake, whatever you want to call it. And, as far as things are looking right now, it's going to be a good night. I have a lot planned for us. It is going to be a night that, there's going to be so much Rogue One love. But before we get to that, I want to start off by saying, if you have any suggestions for the show, ideas for things we should talk about, discussions, we're going to be doing a lot of stuff for movies, TV, comic books, probably merchandise like Pops and Funkos and a ton of other stuff. Like, we're going to try to cover a pretty wide spectrum in this hour, hour and a half. And especially since I don't have Leo here, I'm going to have to be really, really talkative and moving around because I'm going to have to do discussion basically with myself and with you guys in the comments. Hopefully Leo, he's helping me out from the comments too. He's sick, which is why he's not here today. He didn't just not show up. Sorry, I should explain that earlier. Regardless, I'm going to ask that anyone who has questions, please hit us on our Twitch channel. I'm going to be trying to monitor that chat there, because it's updated live with the video. You can hit us on our Facebook, at Comicovnos. We got a page. And then you can hit us also on Twitter, either by tagging us at Comicovnos with comic and then convos with C's. Usually it's just Comicovno, one C. Or you can do hashtag Comicovnos, Comicovnos. And I'm going to be monitoring those two for any questions, suggestions, ideas, thoughts, get into a discussion with me. I'm not doing jack shit, honestly. We're here. Oh, I probably shouldn't curse if this is for children. My bad. Haha, no bleep. We don't have our delay long enough for this. I'm also going to have to go over here and turn some other stuff off. Hopefully we're not lagging too much or stuck on anything. If we are, let me know, guys. I'm going to be trying to pay attention to it, but it's a lot going on, obviously. So for now, we're going to jump it right into our first section, which hopefully we're going to keep these sections kind of consistent with every episode. And we're going to jump into movies! Movies, which the reason being it's kind of the most accessible of the media formats right now. And I know it's like, TV, but the thing about TV is you got to buy TV, obviously. The movies, it's like, $10 to $13, I can go watch something new. And even more than that is like kind of the experience of going to the movies as opposed to TV. But anyway, let's get into the more detailed stuff of what we're doing. We're going to start with some recent releases. And obviously, I have to hit the most like big recent release, which I've seen personally. Obviously, there's probably been a couple movies released, blah, blah, blah. Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. Oh my God. So good. And I know, and here's the thing, I am a movie lover. I'm not a movie critic. Okay, you're not going to get a ton of exposition out of me unprodded. I mean, you might give me the talk, but I'm not going to, like, break down all the movie's flaws first. I'm going to try to think about what I liked about the movie, if it was, I liked the movie, it was good. And Rogue One was everything I wanted and more. Oh, my God. Oh, God. It was simply amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. I went to see it with Leo. Sorry, we're probably getting pauses and stuff. And we went IMAX. Basically, I think we were... Wait, was it Centennial or Superior? I drive a bunch of places. So we were out there. But we went IMAX 3D. We went Leo and another friend who will remain nameless because we try not to mention people. D, you know who you are. It was a blast hanging. I just don't know if you're comfortable with me throwing your name out on the podcast. So, you know, got to kind of remain a little discretionary. We went, we saw it. It was so great. Oh, my goodness. All right, so you start off and you're like, what is going on? Because you basically start off on just some random fucking planet. And oh, my God, what's going on? There's some people and they've made a life here and they've made all sorts of different blah blah blah, and they're getting ready, and oh my God, when Empire comes, they come hard, man. Granted, you like this, and I hate to pull the distinction too much to police or whatever, but like, you know, she pulled a gun on the Empire, but they were kidnapping her husband, so you know, what are you gonna say about that? Sorry, I thought I heard a phone, can't find it, gonna have to do that later. Hopefully someone will hit me up on Facebook or YouTube or Twitch, the Twitch line, wherever it is. Rogue One. Okay, yep, it is that definitely the blurred, and Leo is the critic. Yep, Leo would be over here dissecting the shit out of it. But me, basically, I enjoyed it thoroughly. There's obviously some parts that are, you know, you can call into question. But so we go from that, and we get a little bit more of the backstory on the Death Star and the designing of, and Leo's going to be so mad at me because I'm bad with names. So I'm not going to be able to name people, like anybody's name. I cannot remember the father's name for whatever reason. But the main character, which I believe is... yeah, you're going to hate me. I swear to God, because I don't know anyone's name. Oh, God. This is so bad. But basically, the heroine of the story... we learn about her past and how her father was designing the Death Star and left and tried to flee because he knew what they were doing. It was a planet killer. I mean, that's terrifying. And they find him, and he tries to say that his wife's dead. You know, doesn't have a family. His wife shows up. They go looking for the daughter because they know. I don't know how the Empire knows, but they always know. People talk. And she gets saved by Forrest Whitaker's character, who obviously, you know, is an interesting character, and you gotta, I'm pretty sure, and I've heard about this, I gotta watch more Clone Wars. He, Saw Gerrera, yeah, Saw Gerrera, I can't say the name right, but, Saw, I was gonna take you there. Anyway, too much spoilers, sorry, I should have said all that first. God, I'm terrible at this already. But, besides that, you know, we get into more of the story, you know, I'm not gonna go into details, but she goes to kind of find her father, and that's kind of the main plot of the story, is her going to find her father, who's been taken to blah blah blah, finish the Death Star, which we don't know this is the Death Star. But basically, the thing about Rogue One is it is not only a great movie by itself, with basically no Jedis except for Vader in like probably a total of 5 minutes of footage max. Worth it, totally worth it. The teasers, I almost wasn't like, oh, the teasers. But, you know, what you gonna do about it? I mean, seriously. Besides that, you know, the rest of the story is focused on the Rebels and then, like, okay, how do we get this death plot? How do, you know? And the thing about it is it makes four more relevant. The New Hope, suddenly obviously, there's never all the plot holes are filled. But a lot of the plot holes are filled in four. And I don't want to go into too specifics, but it's like, blah, blah, blah. Achilles' heel, and I don't want to go, like I said, I've already done too many spoilers as is, like on the opening and stuff, but there is a healthy amount of comedy, there is a lot of good storyline and backstory, there's not, I can't really think of a part where that's an unnecessary scene necessarily. You know, me and Leo discussed this at one point that there are sometimes scenes in movies where you're like, well, what's the point of this? We need to keep moving the story. Oh my god. Oh yeah, I love it. I'm loving the comments from Leo right now. It's so truthful. Filled up for like a glass of water, gallon. Urso, Jin, Urso, see, he knows everybody. God damn it. I need to look at the chat more and not curse as much. But, you know, episode one, not going so bad. Episode one of Star Wars, everybody hates it, but ignore Jar Jar Binks and it's not a terrible movie. I'm just saying. Everybody hates Jar Jar Binks too much and don't let themselves enjoy it. Granted, man, there was a lot of Jar Jar. Off that, no more critiquing one. We're going to move a little bit off Rogue One, which we actually are going to return to Rogue One, I feel like, here in a minute. Just because of some of the content we have later in the show, TV, movie, etc., games. You know, besides that recent release, I know Assassin's Creed was recently at least either released or preview released, partially because I know Leo has gone to see it because he was talking about it and posted about it. I've heard mixed reviews. Some people say it's meh, and some people say it's terrible. I haven't heard anyone say it's great yet, but I haven't heard Leo's review either. He's probably still getting ready for it. You know, the thing about making video games into movies is they often stray far, far too much from either the video game idea, title, or just the pacing and style of the video game. I don't know. And some video games aren't meant to be movies. Not saying Assassin's Creed isn't. I think Assassin's Creed makes a great video game. I love the first Assassin's Creed. I'm not sure that's this one. I think they did some slight tweaking. But the original had such depth and history and geography, etc., and culture, that it was a joy to play. Game review, get to that later. Let's see, what else have we done? Fantastic Beasts. Once again, I've heard people either are kind of okay with it, and just like, meh, and then people like me, who enjoys movies, really just enjoy it. I try to get a lot of enjoyment out of it if I can. Yep, alright, so Leo has confirmed the Assassin's Creed film has a new storyline. I won't go into depth about that because I cannot talk about it. I haven't seen it. I'll let you guys check out Leo when he's going in. I'm glad we're not having too much lag because I can see Leo's at least like 20, 30 seconds behind me. You know, you could check out his blog at The Blurred or some of his reviews and stuff. He will probably definitely have something of it about that soon, or maybe even already does that I don't know about. Fantastic Beasts was dope, to quote Leo The Blurred. Same universe, new storyline. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. And in America, great. Oh, God. And like I said, there I go again with no names. I'm sure Leo will hit me with them in about 30 seconds, so I better not look too hard for him. I really should have had some of this up or previewed some of this stuff, bounced it around. But basically, Fantastic Beasts is a British beast, care tamer, blah, 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 comes to America, you know, and loses his briefcase to a muggle or a non-mage. That's it. A non-magic. I remembered it. It only took me forever. And, you know, it's fairly nice. I don't know. I didn't mind that at all. Like, I read all of the Harry Potter books except for the new Fantastic Beasts because I heard it was a play, which it's supposed to be a play, from what, you know, I assume. I'll have to go check it out sometime. Like I said, I'm always behind on this stuff. You'll always be behind on this stuff, so you just gotta catch it where you can. Newt Scamander, this is correct. And, oh man, like I said, this is classic. Even stuff like, man, years and years of dead brain cells from Don't You Mind. Anyway, you know, this is a great movie. I don't want to ruin it too much. I just wanted to kind of go over it and say, you know, the obviously, the effects are amazing, as in all the Harry Potter movies. They've progressively get better, obviously, but this one's great because you get to see beasts and some craziness. Rhinoceros is all I gotta say. That's my only breakdown. Oh, also fancy hat for Fantastic Beasts. Good stuff. Anyway, fathead. You know, Fantastic Beasts is definitely a great movie. You gotta check it out. Perpentina is a Deuterogamist. I'm supposed to be a scholar. I feel ashamed. I don't deserve that medal I got. I'm just kidding. Not really, though. Obviously, like I said, hit us with some questions if you like to at hashtag Comicovnos with an S and one C, Comicovnos. I know, confusing. But, you know, we do what we can. And we're going to keep bringing you some more kind of recent movie news with Doctor Strange. I know it's a little more recent, or a little less recent than the others, but got a Comic-Con, but we got to discuss Doctor Strange. How can we not discuss Doctor Strange? That would be criminal. Like, lock me up and throw away the king. Clean the second main character. Oh man, that's true. I didn't discuss the second main character of Fantastic Beasts, who is a female detective-ish. Kind of like... The Auroras. I can't say the one from Harry Potter. The Magic Police, who was pursuing Newt for the Magic Beast infraction of importing blah blah blah, because it's illegal in America to have Magic Beast because the non-mages blah 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 blah. You also get to view a new enemy. In Fantastic Beasts. Oh, God. See, this is why I need a list of these things beforehand. Next time, people, I swear we'll have it. Oh, God, not the adorableness. I mean, we got the... Oh, God. The Nifflers. Oh, God, which is... Wouldn't it be Nickler or something? Oh, the Yerumpent. Man, they do have creative names. Mertlap. I really just wanted the thing that happens when a squib can't put its magic out, but, you know, I guess I'm not gonna know that one unless Leo looks it up, because I'm not gonna go too depth into it. Ah, yes. Credence, enemies being Percival. It's Sister Queenie, yes! Oh, God, Queenie, who can read minds. And, oh, I love that there's so much comedy. Gotta enjoy it. Also, no wasted scenes. Very concise. Grindelwald. So many spoilers. Don't want to do too many spoilers. And we're 20 minutes and we can't allot too much time. We got a couple different sections. But Fantastic Beasts, fantastic movie. Hashtag check out Leo the Blurred. I am absolutely sure he probably has a review on that. As that has been out a while. You can also obviously go see the movie. And support cinema. You know, also support free media by, you know, supporting us. We'll hopefully be doing this every week. You know, that's the goal. Ooh, did we finally get a tag or a thing? I can never tell because I'm bad at Twitter. There it is. Favorite moments in Doctor Strange. Thank you again from Leo. We'll get more post eventually, but as long as it keeps going consistently every week, that's the goal. As long as the cast goes, that's the goal. And Doctor Strange, oh God. Favorite moment in Doctor Strange is a tough one because the entire movie is really, in my opinion, solid. Like, don't get me wrong, there's high parts and low parts, and oh gosh. I have to say the scene with the cloak. And this doesn't necessarily ruin the story, but it will ruin a little bit of the comedy if you know it's kind of coming. So, spoiler alert here on Doctor Strange is that at a scene while defending one of the centers of magic, you know, the strongholds, and I believe it's either England or Hong Kong, we see that Strange comes by a cloak, and if... Oh, man. if you have ever read a Doctor Strange comic, you will know this cloak, because it's, yeah, I should have known, because it's such a simple name. I just want it to be so much complicated, or just kind of like the, Eye of Agamotto, but it's not. It's just a cloak of levitation, which you see the Eye of Agamotto too, obviously. Great moment. It's pretty close together in both of those. And it is an amazing moment in Doctor Strange where the cloak comes out and helps him in the middle of fighting these dark, I guess, magicians, wizards, whatever you want to call them in Doctor Strange's world, but really they're servants of Dormammu, which they do talk about. Dormammu. Dormammu is a villain. Also, and I actually have criticisms of every movie, of course. I didn't talk about them in Star Wars and Fantastic Beasts, because I want you to like the movies and I want you to go see them, but Star Wars, my biggest criticism is Tarkin's very first scene as CGI is incredibly, incredibly obvious. After that, also spoiler, by the way. After the first scene, it is not so obvious, because I think they pick more angles, less direct FaceTime, and less concurrent lines. Like, that first scene with Tarkin is fucking face full of CGI. Fantastic Beasts. Actually, do I have a criticism of Fantastic Beasts? No, not off the top of my head. I'm sure there's something that's, you know, will come to mind eventually, but currently there's nothing I can think of right off the top of my head about Fantastic Beasts, except for everyone who has a complaint in that Harry Potter's not in it, but I didn't care because I knew Harry Potter wasn't going to be in it, so why would I give a crap if he wasn't in it, if I knew he wasn't going to be in it? Why are you mad about that? Anyway, Doctor Strange, and this is kind of the hashtag for the backwards, is my least favorite moment is Dormammu. I was not, like, I like the effect, blah, 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 but I wanted classic Dormammu, flaming head Dormammu. And I know that I'm not the biggest Doctor Strange fan to even be demanding this, but, like, through the Spider-Man cartoons, through the comic books, through even some other, I want to say other things, I swear, I tell you that, you know, I really wanted to see it. I thought it would be great. Besides that, that entire scene with Dormammu was freaking amazing. Spoilers. Dark Dimension also looked a little like, it looked kind of like in the comic book though, which I thought I did enjoy, but I feel like the Dormammu threw me off. And, but that scene, spoiler, of Strange dying again and again, timelessness, is really kind of fun and cool and a good concept to go with. I thought that was amazing. One of the great ways to kind of trick and beat Dormammu, and, you know, just all around a great scene. Probably one of the best in the movie. I love the levitation cloak scene personally, but the whole thing is amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Just stay about it. Better Dormammu, yeah. Alright, that's true. Fantastic Beasts had a couple moments where it might have been, like, getting move on. I don't know if they were necessarily, like, totally wasted, but they definitely could have been faster or more concise. They were, like, a very ambient, like, hanging out at his place when they go into his suitcase. Spoiler. Mary Poppins, bitch. And cursing. We'll still work on that. Alright, so we're coming up on a half hour here, so we're going to try to kind of just move through the upcoming releases really quickly. Not super quickly, but mostly really quickly, because there's not so much a lot to discuss as compared to these ones that we've already discussed. Doctor Strange being great. Great origin story, too, by the way. Doctor Strange, kind of reminiscent of Iron Man. I think there was a lot of consensus about that being very, very reminiscent of the Iron Man origin story, in that it kind of explained him and introduced him in a very concise manner, made him this character that could stand up in the current Marvel Universe without being questioned. Because of the Eye and the Infinity Stone, blah, 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 blah. Spoilers. Spoilers! The whole thing should be titled Spoilers! Okay. We're going to move on through a couple of the new releases that are really comic and, you know, blah, 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 nerdy, totally related. We've got Logan, which I believe is one of the most coming up-ish, you know. supposedly the last of the Wolverines for Hugh Jackman. Gonna be a great Old Man Logan kind of cross-off. It's not gonna be the same, obviously. They didn't keep the same storyline. That's okay. That storyline was dark as hell. If you've never heard it, it is basically murder, 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 and Wolverine, and villains, and holy shit, man. So bad. And Hulk's a villain, and everything just went to crap. So the new one's hopefully more optimistic. I mean, it looks like Apocalypse, but hey, Professor X is alive in this one. Spoilers. And we're gonna see Death. We're seeing the Reavers, who are classic Wolverine villains. Sinister, who is kind of more of a Summers villain, but you see him, and he's an X-Men villain. Essex Corps, they've already kind of set it up in the last movie. You know, we're gonna see this. This is gonna happen. We've got the Old Man Logan, who can't heal that well. And I'm looking forward to it. I love Wolverine. He's definitely my favorite character, so I'm biased. I know a lot about him, if anyone wants to know. Yes, and Ryan Reynolds wants to get Jackman to stay, but it's going to be tough, and it's a lot of it's a licensing issue thing, obviously. I'm sure that Ryan Reynolds can figure it out, because he figured it out with his loyal online army before. Man, that guy should run for president. I'm just kidding. But hey, man, I mean, celebrities can do it now, man. I'm looking forward to it. I'm definitely look so fucking sick. I don't think that there's any question that this is going to be a good Wolverine movie. I don't think they can fuck it up. I mean, I thought that about not Origins, but the other Wolverine one. But whatever. They probably can't mess it up. We're going to go on to Spider-Man Homecoming. Oh, God. The trailer was everything we wanted and more. Out of Tom Holland. I'm sorry to, you know, previous Spider-Mans, Tobey Maguire, and the second guy. People are going to be mad that I don't know him, but I just don't know him because I'm bad with names, not because he wasn't a good Spider-Man. They were both good Spider-Mans. I thought they were fine. There was problems with Spider-Man 3 and problems with each of their individual castings that I hope Tom Holland makes up for. He's doing a very young Spider-Man. Hopefully this very young Spider-Man's gonna give us what we want. Toby sucks. Toby was good in the first movie. Like, not great. And Andrew Garfield was, oh man. The thing is, they were both aspects of Spider-Man. They just weren't Spider-Man. Everyone wants that perfect Spider-Man, but it's hard because Spider-Man is this iconic kind of teenish college guy that just wants to do the right thing and struggles and has a hard time in life and is just kind of a loser in general, except for the fact that he's a superhero, he's Spider-Man. And obviously today Spider-Man in the comics is not that way. We'll get into that later. Hopefully, we've got time, obviously, still another hour, and we've only got a couple more sections. But all in all, we are looking forward to this. The Vulture, Michael Keaton's Vulture is hopefully going to be great. He's great at playing bird people. Bird! I love that Leo's like, all right, I was a little harsh. No, I totally understand, especially after seeing Andrew Garfield and Tom, seeing Tom Holland, or Andrew Garfield and Toby don't seem quite too far because he has very much the kiddish banter that we liked. Garfield, to a degree, had that, but he did not have the... He had more of, I don't know, it was a different kind of charm. And the problem also was the inconsistencies in the storylines, the powers and stuff. Like, and this one, we've kind of glossed over that a bit, and we're seeing more of the kind of new age Spider-Man hooked up with the Avengers, which a lot of people are kind of angry at because it's not canon, but there's so much Spider-Man canon now with the Spider-Verse. And so many things with the retro, with the Mary Jane and the kid thing, and there's just a lot of going on with Spider-Man to the point that this is fine, this is cinema, this is, not only that, this is Fox. Like, this is not, no, wait, they did incorporate Iron Man, so it's Marvel. Crap. Right, okay, so, but still, it's at least them reaching out and figuring out what's going on, and they're trying to make amends with their past. Like, you know, we've taken the past mistakes, you know, Foreman being Venom, Tobey Maguire being Spider-Man. Okay, yeah, Toby shouldn't have been Spider-Man. He's just such a sad Spider-Man. And I know you lost Uncle Ben, but this reminds me of the Uncle Ben, stop killing me, Kent and Martha Wayne. Or Thomas and Martha Wayne. Not Kent, blah. Thomas and Martha Wayne, don't even start with us. Lol. But still, Spider-Man Homecoming with the addition of the web gliders, with the addition of the Iron Man, with showing his power to the degree that it actually is holding the cruise ship was a great scene. Showing his comedy, dodging, there's a lot that even in that short commercial shows for a good Spider-Man. I know this is going to come and bite me in the ass because it's never going to be perfect, but it's going to be hopefully good. So we've got Logan, we've got Spider-Man Homecoming, we're going to cover a couple more Marvel ones. Guardians of the Galaxy. Man, Guardians of the Galaxy 2. This is going to be a doozy. I mean, you are going to get a C. It's supposed to be bigger and badder in every way, and from what we've seen in the trailers, it is. It's going to be an amazing movie. You got Baby Groot, you've got all your classics, they're bringing in Mantis, you've got Yondu and the Ravagers coming back at him, and it's got to all somehow tie back into the Infinity Wars at some point, or at least partially tie back into the Infinity Wars and the Avengers. So I'm looking forward to how they're doing that. I'm going to guess either a Thor connection or maybe a Doctor Strange connection even, which would be a great pace. He's just everywhere at once. Strange is a monster in the Marvel Universe. We can talk about more of that in comics when we have a little more time. We're kind of glossing through movies and trying to get past it, because we still have TV and graphic novels and then a couple social media things. Those won't take long at all, but we got a couple of those things going. We'll also stop again for questions and answers after this. And we'll get more of the ball rolling, hopefully. So, the next one we obviously have to talk about is Justice League. Batman's coming too, don't get me wrong. But Justice League, we've seen pictures, we've seen the commercial, we've seen the Aquaman as Jason Momoa, Ben Affleck's Batman we've already seen, we've seen everybody. We've got Wonder Woman, obviously, on the way too. And this is all in the same kind of vein of the DC Universe. And what we've got to see now is if they move on from their past mistakes, and I'm going to say this because I'm the critic on this one, because it's just, you got to remember, if I'm saying it's not good, you might want to take heed because I like everything. That Batman vs. Superman, Dawn of Justice, not my favorite comic movie. There was a lot of fuzzy stuff. Great graphics, but there was a lot of, why are we watching this? There was a lot of unanswered questions. There's a lot of what the fuck moments, like, Martha, you know what I mean? And we just didn't, I don't feel like we got the what we were looking for, especially with so much content to be pulled from of them fighting before. You see a lot of content of them in animated movies and comic books and fan fictions, whatever you take your pick. You could pick a million crazy different things. There were some great things, Kryptonite gas. Anyway, getting caught up on past. But Justice League looks to be hopefully promising. They're going to have Cyborg. They're having the Flash. We're going to see Aquaman, Wonder Woman, Superman. I think they said Shazam. They're supposed to be making Shazam. We'll see how that ends up. Don't go too dark, guys. Don't go too light, but don't go too dark. Have comedy. Comedy is essential. And above that, even, guys, get the fights in. Oh, my God. Fight more. People love it when they fight. Even when they fight each other, they don't even have to fight villains anymore. People love it when the heroes fight each other. It's selling like crazy. Read Civil War 2. Read Injustice. Read any of those. They're going freaking mad. I'm trying to think if there's any other really great upcoming Star Wars besides, or any great sci-fi and comic book movies coming up. All I can think of is the next Star Wars and, you know, anime titles, blah, blah, blah. Stuff that's not relevant. So, you know, we took the question a little earliest time. Usually this would be where we answered a question from the section. So we'll get used to asking that. But for now, we're going to move on to our next section. Not too bad for 35 minutes. Of movies, if we can also come back to this at post-show, blah, 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 if we feel like it. we're going to move on to TV. And there's so much great TV to talk about in this category, especially recently. Holy crap, there is so much going on TV, most especially for DC. I have to give it to DC here, even though I'm probably more of a Marvel fan than a DC fan. I'm a fan of both. But I know more Marvel and I've read more Marvel, so it's easier for me to compare. And I can compare, at least even in my bias subtext, that DC has a great TV universe. And they've honestly always kind of had the edge on that. And a lot of people don't give Smallville the credit it deserves, but I'm going to just take a second and give credit to Smallville. You know, new actors, etc., a lot of CGI, trying to get the work in. They put a lot of work in that show, and it paid off. I was a kid, I liked it. It's kind of where I learned a little bit and where I was kind of introduced to Superman even more so, except for the Justice League comics, or animated shows, which we'll always talk about as well. Those were also great, and they've... I want to say that DC's probably had the edge on those, too, for a little while. With us, maybe some small exceptions, but probably not. And, there we go. Sorry, I had to find a phone, which was trapped in a thing. And now they have the live-action TV shows locked down. Some are good, some are bad, but you've got some great shows like Gotham and Flash. Great shows. If you've seen them, you know what I'm talking about. And you probably agree with me. If you don't agree with me, go. No, I'm just kidding. We respect all opinions. And you probably don't like it for a reason, hopefully, and not just because. It's honestly, they're great adaptions. They're great the kind of prequel series and coming into stories for different characters. They provide a lot of backstory development, a lot of crossover potential, good effects, etc., directing. I'm biased, like Kevin Smith. I like Kevin Smith, so the episodes he's done on The Flash I thought were great. Same for the episode he did of Supergirl recently, which I saw and I thought was great. I'm not totally caught up on everything. Need to get caught up? No. See, told you, never caught up. Man, I need to be caught up if I'm going to be doing this show, so I'm going to have to spend some time doing this. Still, Gotham, from the last time I checked, was going in a great direction of... Now we've evolved past that point of Galavant, and we're going into the new Mad-Eye Mooney slash the new era of super-powered villains phase, and really the organized villain. We got Penguin Selection. Oh, God, so much going on. Flash is going into his third season of how come every other speedster is faster than me, which is hashtag question of all time Flash. Like... You know what I mean? I gotta ask, like, why, Flash? Why is every speedster faster than you? We'll talk about more about that in comics, but even in the TV show, man, he just gets kicked in the face. And it is a great, great, great show. Check out The Flash. If you haven't seen it, go through. They got 2 seasons on Netflix, I believe now. If not, they got 1. Go to Hulu and watch most of the season 2, too. Man, you slacking Hulu. Get the rest of season 2 up. It's been way too long already. Unless they're doing 3 now. I don't even know. Right? Leo's like, ding. Oh, God. That's true. Barry in the TV show isn't Barry. It's also kind of because they're going for that kid angle. But I totally agree. The actor, as much as the show does a good job, he is not specifically Barry Allen. Like, the way even the show portrays Barry Allen is probably not as Barry Allen as you'd think. There's a lot... I mean, and don't get me wrong, Barry is driven by his mother. We'll talk more about that in comics and maybe when we'll do contrast, but... Gotta get more Barry. Gotham, Supergirl... I'm not the biggest follower of Arrow. I've watched the first and I've heard good things. I also heard it was a lot about eye candy, which is kind of what turned it off for me and which kept me from reading Arrow. But from what I've seen, it can be a good show, and there's depth there. There's a lot of seasons to watch, so if you need to... Yeah, there was also the team of detectives things. That's true, but Barry has always worked closely with Star Labs, at least. Maybe not specific scientists or a team, but he's always worked with Star Labs in general as the Flash to help solve crimes. He never needed anybody, necessarily, except for Iris. He always needs Iris. And Barry is a very intelligent man, and he's a genius in the comics. Please, you know, read them if you get the chance to learn more about Barry Allen, as is Wally West and a couple other people. I mean, I like DC, but they're not as pronounced sometimes about letting their characters be known as scientific geniuses, kind of like Banner and Stark are. They're very much in the forefront of their position as science. Even though, that's the thing, you feel like, despite the fact that Flash gets his powers from a science accident / nature accident, and the Speed Force, it's true, Barry doesn't need an arsenal. That's what Batman needs. just Josh and Batman. Batman can handle it by himself. Get a lot of Batman hate if I talk crap about Batman. You know, The Flash, great show. Don't want to dwell on it too long because I love it. And we will talk about The Flash all day if I have the choice. But, you know, stay tuned. It's still, I think, mid-season or coming close to the end of the season now with Savitar, etc. Jesse Quick, Wally West. I forgot who the other, they had another new speedster this season who didn't last very long and got killed. You'll see him later. Supergirl, I've actually not kept up on that one either, but I've seen the whole first season. Not bad. Enough to keep me slightly interested and at least take up my day. Most of my day while I'm at work, so, you know, hey, check it out. Keep you busy. And the crossovers are hopefully worth the crossover time. Besides that, I don't believe there's too much DC to get into. I don't know if Neo has any ideas of something that I'm missing, but I think that's, for the most part, DC's TV lineup. Previously, they might have stuff coming up. But for all that DC's, fairly juvenile. True. Supergirl is definitely juvenile, and I feel like it's very stereotypical for, like, Barry, like, and maybe not accurately stereotypical, but stereotypically trying to market towards a very specific woman comic fan base. Like, definitely there's some male, blah, 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 but I feel like it's very much marketed towards women. DC's Arrowverse, man. That's true. The crossovers were the cleanest. But they did those right because I feel like the production team for The Flash pulls a lot together. Like, the storyboard team and stuff, like, they have to put a lot of work into making that stuff accurate. And I hate to say it, but as much as I like new ideas, etc., sticking to the comic books, they've done these good ideas. You just need to reformat them in a way that's presentable, and when you don't go too far away from the source material, the comic book fans love it. The shoutouts, that's why the Supergirl episode that Kevin Smith directed, I thought was not very fluff and was very good, was because it was a direct shout-out to Old School Crisis, and holy crap, there was a lot of references and depth to that story as opposed to some of the other very facile story from Supergirl that happens in like an episode or two and you're done. You have no overarching villains-ish. They did in the first season, don't get me wrong, and they do kind of in the second season, but it's just like, there's this kind of ambiguity of are they enemies, are they friends, are they, etc. So, moving on from the DC universe of what is a mostly current releases, like, I believe they do have some stuff coming out eventually, but nothing really in production that I know of that is releasing very soon. Whereas Marvel currently has stuff releasing, not as much as DC, but will soon have so much releasing, and they do actually have some stuff going on. So if you haven't checked it out, the Marvel Netflix universe is amazeballs, to a point. Luke Cage is amazing, 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 and I know I don't look it, but I relate to it a little more as a minority and coming up in a low-income neighborhood, obviously, but still, I thought it was very shout-outy to original Luke Cage, gives the character of Luke very well, circumstances, the backstory, introduction, are done well over a time period for a TV series. You've got the more previous Jessica Jones and Daredevil, and Daredevil Season 2, which is, in my opinion, way better than Season 1, just because they got the Punisher and Elektra. Check that shit out. So much story there I cannot get into. Luke Cage is dope. A bulletproof brother. Harlem couldn't handle him. Had to make special bullets, which I was just like, god damn. And great part about that too is they bring in Hammer, which is such a Marvel shot. Like I said, and they even shouted out the tiara and the bracelets and the yellow shirt. Holy shit, keep to the accuracy. Add stuff if you want, but oh my god, the accuracy. Cottonmouth, Diamondback, that's so fucking accurate. You have no clue if you haven't read Luke Cage, but oh my god. They were just short of the afro, basically. Now, regardless, it's a great show that you'll... I can tell you... I can't tell you it's spoilers, but the ending, man. Check it out. Luke Cage on Netflix. Jessica Jones, I'm not necessarily going to recommend. I don't necessarily think it was my favorite, but it's because I'm not a crime drama-ish kind of guy. Thing is, it was very blurring the lines between crime drama and superhero drama slash action. Because Jessica Jones has these powers, but and the Purple Man has these powers, but at the same time, it's this convoluted game, kind of like in Daredevil, where you're trying to find proof and legal and, you know, legality, etc., etc. You know, the Purple Man was... Actually, I thought the acting was great on the Purple Man, which was what made me stay, and how they depicted him as so cruel and vicious. The only thing I was unhappy of, and they eventually rectified, was his color, and you'll have to see. You have to watch it, although they kill him, blah, blah, blah. You also gotta check out Daredevil. It was great. Season 1 was very good, a very good intro, but Season 2 is just like a comic book. The action pacing, basically, except for the first couple episodes, just like a comic book. The introduction and the side story of the Punisher, and how it co-mingles with his story. The same with Elektra and the... Oh, God. The Hand, I believe. Is the enemy in this one, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe another ninja organization. But, oh, such accuracy, such great, great feeling. Just can't. Those two alone make up for Jessica Jones. How about that? Even if you don't like Jessica Jones, Daredevil and Luke Cage, and Daredevil's second season being successful, make up for that. And promises of more coming. And that's what we're going to get to now. Because we've covered, you know, also Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is running. If you don't like Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., some people don't even know about it. A friend of mine thought it was canceled. It is not canceled. It's going strong. They're in their season, which I believe is the Ghost Rider season, but it's like season 3 or 4. And I've kept up on that one before, but now I'm a couple episodes behind. And we're going to see how this goes, because I needed to see more accuracy, but it's the Robbie Reyes one, and it looks like they're keeping accurate to the Robbie Reyes Ghost Rider, which... I was always pretty happy with Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Most people don't know this, but since the release, there is actually comic book characters, like, so Daisy Johnson has actually existed in the comic books before she was a character on S.H.I.E.L.D., I believe, and her name is Quake, etc., blah, 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 changes to the thing, that's why they changed her name to Daisy, eventually, was these retcons, etc., and you just gotta check it out. I mean, having Phil Coulson's also a great character. He carries that series. Without Phil Coulson, that series dies. But they added some great stuff in. They've got the side series now, I believe, for the Speedster, which I can't remember her name. Yo-Yo. Check out Yo-Yo. S.H.I.E.L.D.'s pretty good, but I'm really excited for the new rosters. The upcoming stuff in Marvel looks to be as amazing and better than what they have. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is good, but it's your typical show. You know, you catch it to kind of fill the time. You like it. You want to see the new stuff. But it's not something you're amazed. You're not blown out of the water like the first season of Lost. And then it goes downhill. These upcoming series, though, I think they're going to blow your mind, man. And they're going to blow my mind. We've got so much coming up. Punisher. We've got confirmed cast for the Punisher recently. We also didn't talk about upcoming movies earlier too far ahead. But we had Thor Ragnarok, blah, blah, blah. We had Black Panther, which I'm super excited for. Oh my god, that's going to be so great. And they got the correct diversity of the cast instead of the wrong diversity. People, I mean, there's not that much diversity. That's not the way how the words works. But they've got the correct... What's the word? I can't think of it. There's an actual demographic. Yeah, maybe. Close enough. Regardless, you know, we're going to talk about the new shows coming up, and man, the Punisher is going to be great. If they make it as violent as they made those scenes in Daredevil, and make it on Netflix, they're going to make a ton of money off of merchandising, commercials, and just, you know, getting the Netflix hosting rights stuff for streaming, eventually selling physical copies, which you eventually want. I mean, you want that. We've got Iron Fist coming up along that same Defenders line of Luke Cage and Daredevil. And Iron Fist is a great character if you don't know about Danny Rand and the Iron Fist and the city of Kung Lao? I'm bad with the thing. But, you know, also don't forget to ask your questions about TV at hashtag Comicovnos, and we will talk about it at the end of the thing. Sorry, I didn't remember that. I also forgot to tweet that we're live, but, you know, people... I told you what time was coming, I swear. I did. I said it. We gotta be ready for the Iron Fist, man. It's gonna be great. He's a kung fu master and can control his chi, etc., etc. I mean, not to be thing, but he can actually fight with Luke Cage. So if that gives you any kind of perspective of what his power is, of what he's capable of, I hope it does. Man, we're probably getting a lot of freezing on this. I hope there's not too much, but I hope this is gonna be great. Also, it's gonna go straight to YouTube. It's going to be a great series. It's going to be a great series on Netflix, hopefully, for us, and check it out. Now, here's a couple more series coming up, and we don't know exactly... I don't know too many details on both of them, except for I know one's coming out February 8th. Legion is coming, and for those who don't know about Legion, boy, do you have stuff coming for you. Legion is actually, I believe, David Haller, and they talk about that in the... if you've seen the commercial... And, basically, Legion is Professor X's son. He is a telekinetic, and also known as a chronokinetic, who, in the comic books, is so powerful he can time travel with his mind alone. He doesn't actually have time travel abilities, he just time travels using his mind somehow. I don't remember how exactly it works. He's the only person I've seen affect his own causality in comics, basically, where, basically... he goes back and kills his father on accident before he's born, or conceived, blah, blah, blah. He was trying to do it before, she was trying to kill Magneto, long story short, he erases himself from existence, basically, which I've never, almost never, you don't see a character really do that. You see offshoot, blah, 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 but, I mean, he's gone, man, he's gone. But in this one, he seems to be, like, working, or being worked with by the government, or being taken... control over, taught how to use his powers, and he seems to have somewhat same powers, like some kind of manipulation of matter with his mind, some kind of also he's crazy, if you didn't know, get from the storyline, he's freaking insane, like mad crazy. Not his fault, he had like multiple personalities, like a lot. Legion, like a lot, a legion, which I believe is 100, maybe 50, but it's a ton, but you know what I'm saying. And finally, and I know it's a longer ways off, but I thought I'd talk about it real quick because we're moving into our kind of last 30-minute section, and then we'll have to have a little bit of time for social media, so this might last a little more than an hour and a half. But moving into our last section after this, but Inhumans got approved for stuff, or at least approved for like starting to go for stuff. And so hopefully we're going to see that. You're going to see a lot more of the humans because... they're super popular in the comics, apparently, and they're kind of replacing the X-Men. We'll talk about that in comics with more of the series, etc. But, man. I want to see an Inhumans comic for Black Bolt. And I'm really mad for the IVX stuff right now, even though you'll learn more if you read that. Don't want to ruin too much. But, man, the Inhumans Black Bolt is a character... who basically just wrecks a ton of other characters. Like, he's on par with smashing the Hulk and Thor, almost. Not to that point, but he's very, very powerful. Oh my god. Gotta see more Black Bolt. Also Inhumans, man. I just like the Inhumans storyline. They were always cool to me. So, besides... TV, now we're gonna have to go into the real meat of comics convos, which is comics, graphic novels, whatever you want to call them, visual eye candy of a almost deviant nature is what I prefer, but whatever you call them, they're great, and there's a lot of stuff going on. There's so much greatness since Marvel and DC did some reboots. DC did a double, they had their New 52, and now they're on Rebirth, which is so great, way better than New 52, way better. Sorry. Said it. I've caught up on a ton of Rebirth. I'm not fully caught up on everything, obviously. There's a ton of it. But I've read my share now and covered the major bases, and I'm comfortable talking about Rebirth being freaking awesome. Got me loving DC again. Man, I haven't loved DC in this so much in so long. I've read The Flash, Wonder Woman, Batman, Superman, up to date. I'm working my way through Green Lantern Corps. I've done a little bit of some of the side ones. I can't remember specifically which ones. But I'm working my way into them, and I want to go back and do a new 52 to kind of see it, and then obviously go back even farther and read more, because I've read some DC, but it's been so long, and I want to read more and get the continuity correct, because it's all over the damn place. But it's supposedly brought together a little bit, hopefully, in this Rebirth. Man, Rebirth's awesome. Talking about cosmic forces pulling apart reality. Wonder Woman actually covers it more than anybody else, despite the fact that you see the different Superman in a different universe and you see Batman actually talking about it. Wonder Woman actually sees the effects more once you get into her comic books. Man, check out Rebirth. Hashtag Rebirth, man. Hashtag Comicovnos Rebirth. I also forgot to look for the questions on the last section, but I don't think we got any. I'll check again. Nope, but ask questions at hashtag Comicovnos, Comicovnos, for anything you want to talk about relating to comics and graphic novels, whether individual, blah, 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 independent, etc. But definitely Rebirth, check it out. That is DC's mainstay right now. I mean, there's other stuff going on, I'm sure. They've got the, if you have, I don't know if this is an old or recent, I saw it though, is Predator versus Alien versus Judge Dredd, which has got to be great. How can it not be with a name like that, man? Oh, God. Oh, yeah, Rebirth killing it. Besides Rebirth, we've got what's going on in Marvel, which is, man, I didn't think they'd be able to do it again, but man, they're doing Civil War 2. And I've caught up, and I'm mostly on the thing, and they're almost done. I think they're releasing it either next week or the week after. We get the final Civil War chapter in the 8-part trilogy, unless they're doing a 16-er, which would be crazy. And I could see it. But, you know, we gotta say, and by we, I mean me. There's not voices in my head. Anyway, I gotta say, the Civil War and all the side comics, it's really an awesome take again. They're doing a very, it's different than the other one, but in a similar manner. Just this issue that's dividing the heroes. There's a little bit too much copy on the old one, but man, you just get to see some of this fighting. And this one, man, you thought the first Civil War was fucked up. Damn, this one's totally crazy. Spoilers coming up. R.A.P. Bruce Banner, the Hulk. Hearts out forever, Hawkeye, you douche. Taking a dab from heaven. 2016, Harambe, and the Hulk. Motherfucker's been alive since the 60s. At least, damn. I'm, like, legit sad, dude. Like, that was, he was one of my hero characters. Like, I love anti-heroes and the Hulk might be one of the originals, despite people being like, but the Hulk's an anti-hero. Like, he's always fighting that monster within himself and trying to save the day, but the anger gets the best of him, man. And this time it didn't even, but, or he thought, you know. And I know I shouldn't say douchebag Hawkeye, but fuck you, Hawkeye. Fucking douche. Rebirth and Civil War, man. Watch it. There's, shit goes down. Shit goes down hard. And several comics, you gotta read all the Marvel comics obviously to see the effects, because Marvel is, it has now been integrated for several years since probably 2004 or 2003. Recently, before, after the acquisition by Disney, Marvel got its shit together and all of its writers are congruous, except for side universes mostly, and even those have been brought in now after the Secret War reset. And all of their, you know, if you go to Wolverine, that's released during the time of Civil War II, it's Civil War II Wolverine, prelude to Civil War II Wolverine. And you get to see how these events affect these people in the smaller scale and at a smaller level. That's very fucking cool. And kind of like how, like you said, now Rebirth is all over the universe for DC. They're all together. They're integrated, kind of. So too is Marvel now, or more, you know, to an even greater extent. And so, looking forward to see how this ends. We've also got Inhumans versus X-Men IVX coming out, which is just barely really coming out. And man, you've got to see the Death of X series first to really figure that out and see how fucked that is. But holy crap, it is crazy. Crazy, 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 crazy. And I can see why it went all haywire, but damn you. I can't even give it away. I can't even yell out certain names because it give away the whole story. Spoilers. Spoilers, spoilers. Close your ears. Fuck you, Emma Frost. Dumb bitch. I thought he was cray, but I knew he wouldn't do that, and then I was right. Oh, God. Man, I'm still thinking about that scene, because I just recently read Death of X, like a week ago, probably, and man, it's strong, guys. Go read it, all four chapters, holy... Sorry I'm cursing a bunch. Man, that's tough, though. Independent comics, it's been a little while now, but... And it's not new by any means, but to check this out from Image, check out Preacher to honor Steve Dillon, who recently passed. He was also doing work on The Punisher recently, the most recent Punisher to release, which I'm also reading. Great series. Check out Preacher. Check out that Punisher. You will see that Dillon has had some problems, and wherever he's at, I hope he's in a better place. Because man, I gotta imagine either his imaginations, his dreams, or his childhood were freaked. I'm not going to go to him, but yeah, go check out Preacher. I don't know if Leo ever checked it out after I told him, but man, it is a gory piece of graphic novel that, I could see why they asked him to do The Punisher, and he does such an effective job for his art style. A lot of the newer ones are very graphic, comic, these very detailed, intricate drawings, but he doesn't have that style and still manages to convey a level of gore and horror that most people just don't appreciate, I'm sure. But man, whew, it is harsh, harsh, man. Check out Preacher. It is intense. Intense. To move on, that's our Image. You'll have to check it out. I don't want to give any clues away on Preacher. It's its own storyline, and it's too crazy to go over quickly. For my manga overview, we're not going to really discuss too much in depth. I'm literally just going to shoot out some titles that I know of, that I enjoy, that are kind of newer titles that aren't classics like Naruto, One Piece, Berserk, did Dragon Ball Z, all these that people know about, Negima. These are kind of known out there, popular DVD sets. Go check it out. All the subs are out. All the English is out. These ones sometimes don't even have an anime yet. These are manga to a point. Kubera, which I'm trying out for VA fandub or something, but go vote me on castingcallclub.net, whatever. Give me an upvote. Maybe they'll cast me. I want to be Yuta with my... little kid voice. Yeah. No, that's not the voice, but still. Tower of God, if you've never read it. Amazing. God of High School is also great. And this is just a personal favorite. You'll have to find it. It's on, one of the third, fourth party independent manga distributors. But you can find it on, Manga Here. And Manga Fox probably is how I followed some guy with an exposed nipple and found the Zenithian sword. If that title doesn't catch your attention, nothing will. Oh, God. If you can't find it, too, I doubt that you can find it by anything. It is, it's quite a display. You gotta check out the manga more, guys. Manga is on the level of comics, and the comics has some great stuff. I underestimated comics a bit until I got the Marvel U Unlimited package. Check that out, guys. I know it's like 70 or 80, and you don't necessarily get to keep them forever. Wink, wink. Download, screenshot, wink, wink. I'm not encouraging you to do illegal things, wink, wink. But, free sourcing, wink, wink. What I am saying is get that for yourself. Get the $70 subscription and go check them out, man. It is totally worth it. You get 6 months... past, but you get all the old stuff, and they're constantly uploading new old stuff that sometimes you're just not going to find out in a catalog somewhere. I mean, I've read whole series from 40 years ago, reading my way through most of the 1960s X-Men. So crazy, man. So crazy. The very first comic, man. Fucking missiles. Magnosphere. Classics. We're gonna do some more in-depth stuff now in some comic book recommendations. Get ready for some spoilers, baby. These are comic book recommendations from both me and Leo. We both kind of chose a general subject, and since Leo's not here, I kind of asked him, and he gave me his. We'll go with his first. Leo thinks that this comic this week, especially because Rogue One came out last week, and we want to see an independent Darth Vader film, is the new Darth Vader comic coming out with Marvel. Man, they are killing it with the Star Wars connection to Disney. DC, eat your heart out. Man, I am digging that Star Wars. But the Darth Vader comic is seriously amazing, guys. If you haven't checked it out, it's titled Darth Vader, but it's Darth Vader 2015, I believe. It might be 2016, but I believe it started 2015, and they're on like issue 20-something. And this is going to get into some deep Star Wars Legends stuff, which I'm hoping is still canon with Clone Wars, etc., etc. Yo, Vader, woo, woo! Vader is killing it in this, man. If for those who don't know, Vader did indeed betray the Order, blah, 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 lost his love. This comic is showing what most people don't know about Vader in between the conquering of the universe, you know, by the Empire, or, the, you know, the unification of the universe, and the events of A New Hope. And this is actually kind of probably going around even a little before Rogue One and during the time of Rogue One-ish, but mostly before Rogue One, in between 3 and Rogue One, basically, so 3.25, whatever you want to call it. Vader actively hates Palpatine. Like, he recognizes that Palpatine has kind of tricked him into fucking his entire life and, like, killing his love. And, like, he blames himself, too, but he recognizes that he's not in the best position. You know, he has no arms and legs. He's an animatronic monster. No offense to people with no arms and legs. I'm just saying he, specifically Darth Vader, is an emotionless kind of guy. And he's not emotionless. He still loves Padme, and he misses him, and he doesn't know about the children, or if he does, I think he keeps them secret. I can't remember. And if you played any of the Star Wars games, I can't remember specifically which ones, they talk about this as well, how he gets an apprentice per the Sith tradition and wants to overthrow the Emperor and, you know, help restore balance, blah, 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 whatever. I forget what's the game say, but overall, Vader recognizes that Palpatine's evil and wants to destroy Palpatine and stop this overall badness that's happened. And so, people seem to forget that the Vader is definitely villainous, but he's also anti-heroish. But he's definitely villainous. And in this comic book shows his ruthlessness to levels that you, man, he does sacrifice some specific people, but man, he kills everybody. He just sacrifices his whole plan, not plans, but monarchies and all this stuff. Man, you gotta check out that series. Specifically, I was loving he has a doctor, since I cannot remember her name, but who is helping him do these nefarious events of trying to take over the Empire from the Emperor under his nose while still being scrutinized by the Emperor, because the Emperor has done the same thing before and knows that it's coming, is that she has a set of fucking droids that are basically a murderous pair of R2-D2 and C-3PO. I forget their names. But these fucking droids, guys, are like basically murder bots. One's a torture bot, and the other's literally like a murder bot with a bunch of weapons and crazy crap installed, and it's just insanity at its finest. I tell you, insanity at its finest. Gotta check it out. Man, I love Vader. It's like, I definitely did not install systems into these battle droids that would strengthen them if they sucked out your blood and gooey human juices. Oh, God. So great. You guys have to check it out. No lie. Let me be tough. Besides Star Wars, we both agreed some time ago on a series that we thought were cool, and this one is my personal pick, specifically one comic, and I'm not spoiling it for Leo, so careful, Leo, if you haven't read too far into this series, you might want to take a second. But my pick for this week, personally, is Spider-Man and Deadpool Cross. If you haven't seen it, they have a series that's currently coming out and in release. And the specific one I enjoy, that I remember very specifically and is a very enjoyable comic itself, is number 5, in issue 5. And for those who have seen, read this issue, you know exactly why I love this issue and why it's crazy and also why I kind of hate it and why it's stupid. And this is the issue where Deadpool kills Spider-Man. Spoilers. Spoilers, spoilers, sirs. Spoilers, spoilers. I warned. Let me go about this another crazy way. Not only does he kills him twice. And the second time I can kind of see, but the first time is so goddamn stupid. Spider sense, man. It's like, oh, he's just waking up. No, spider sense. This is the same thing happened in Deadpool Kills the Marvel Universe. It's like, oh, I just magically shoot him because I can, even though no one can magically shoot Spider-Man. Magic. Oh, man. That'll have to wait for the end of this segment, but that's a good question. Unless somebody submit another one! No? No? Alright, well, besides that, we've got... Yeah, you gotta check that out. He kills Spider-Man. And obviously brings him back and kills him again, and things tells wrong, and there's this whole story behind it, and you gotta check it out. It's so stupid. It ties directly into Spider-Man's main story, which is also dumb how they keep that so together. It's so well put together, the way they do that. I think I enjoy that so much. Those two series are amazing. And we have now reached the end of our comic section, so I can address this question. Another one posed by Leo, and it's a tough question. And, man, I almost have to frame this question for myself in several ways. But Rebirth or Civil War 2? Oof. I've read a decent amount of both, sir. And I'm a heavily biased Marvel fan. This is still tough for me. New Rebirth is good stuff. And New Marvel... And the reason it's tough is... Okay, so here's the thing. Which story do I think is better? Probably Civil War 2. Because of the way it's structured and the information we have, it's less kind of mysterious and more central in its story integrity than Rebirth. Rebirth is like, oh, there's this big thing, but it's like, oh, there's this big thing, but it's kind of on the side, and we're kind of dealing with it, and we're kind of dealing with it together, but we've also definitely got our own shit to deal with, and we are not taking a break from that at all. You know, we've all got our own issues, and there's no way that we can just take that moment out of our publication thing because we're so new. Marvel is still working, yes, on its new Secret Wars, but it's been out a year already. Marvel's cemented that it's new after Secret Wars. It's still popular enough to keep going. It's no longer in fear that its new universe is going to be rejected by its fan base. It's been accepted, basically. It's been proven they're cool to do basically what they want and experiment. Rebirth can't focus too much on this new overarching crisis, first of all, because it's the impetus for the new Rebirth movement. So if they did that, then obviously you would have this conflict of, oh, we've solved the problem now. There's no overarching problem at all. You know, they'd have to invent a new problem. But also because they're so new. We're hitting chapter 13 on these. You know, that's barely a year out. Maybe, you know, come on. They're now ready to start addressing it, but they've had to put their feet in and dig in and say, okay, this is the Rebirth universe. This is the storyline direction we're going with. This is what we want to do with the universe and how the universe problems come together and get solved and what we're doing about it. Civil War II, the story's there, the universe is there, the problems are there, the issues are real, and they're very contentious. Like, you know, you obviously pick a side, but you see how, well, it's hard to argue with saving lives, you know? Now, personally, which one do you enjoy reading? It's hard to, for me to read Civil War II. Civil War II pulls those heartstrings tight in ways that, yes, you know, you saw Superman this and that in Rebirth, but Rebirth hasn't been tugging you that hard. There's a couple, don't get me wrong. And I don't want to give away so much, so I'm going to yell spoilers now, but, you know, read Batman and Red Robin. R.I.P., buddy. Miss ya. Sorry, Tim Drake. Damn, sir. But, you know, like I said, the Hulk's a long-standing character. We lose other people, too. Oh, God, Rhodey. It's the whole impetus, basically, for Civil War II. And then, like I said, you get the Inhumans and the X-Men involved, and they're already beefing, and I don't even know how that ties in to Civil War II, if it's before or after. Because then it kind of makes me question the whole Civil War X2 lines from X-Men. And why make, oh God, it's so crazy. There's so much left to see and do, and there's so things. So honestly, it's hard to pick for me, but I'd say Civil War II is probably the better storyline. But I'm enjoying reading Rebirth more because it's more about discovery, and it's more about this new universe, and it's less of the dingy darkness sometimes that DC was at some points and is in the movie universe. It's a very much brighter DC sometimes than we're used to. Even in Batman, there's, you know, you've got Gotham going up, and granted, it got dark, it stayed DC, it stayed in these places, but it's fun to read. The ideas are kind of new and kind of classic at the same time, and I'm enjoying them, so it's, you know, one and one. It's tough. Nice. You know, I think that's it for our comic section, and so we've got about 10 minutes left, give or take. And so now, oh, you know, we were a couple minutes late, but it's fine. Now we're gonna do some of our social media stuff. We're gonna give you, you know, check us out on Tumblr, on Twitter, on Facebook at Comicovnos. You know, you can check us out on Twitter. It's at Comic Convos with 2 C's. At everywhere else, it's Comic Convos with 1 C. You know, send us messages, send us ideas, send us topics. If you want to come on the show, we're Denver-based. Let us know. It's toasted in a room with a blanket and a hat. Ha! But before we go, we'll go over some social media stuff, some a little quick things. We'll hopefully post some of these later on the Comic Convo page, Twitter, and Tumblr. You know, and I'm also gonna go over the live stash, which is a section that I hadn't had planned, but I thought it would be interesting to start doing, especially because I know my friend the Blurred does some pump Funko Pop stuff, photo-wise, that I thought being video-wise might also be a good thing for his shout-out stuff. He can get some extra credit for his thing. First, though, we're gonna go over the social media stuff. We're gonna go over some quotes, etc., etc. And we're gonna pick out some quotes. And facts, you know, that we've seen or thought were cool, and things and that are either proved or based, or that we found and thought were accurate enough to be included in the broadcast. We'll start with quotes, and mostly because I don't have one from Leo. I know he had one from about Batman earlier, from Batman earlier about Superman, where it was Batman basically saying, "I'm gonna mess this up," but see, and that's the difference between, or, and that's the difference. He could crush me into the concrete if he wanted, but he won't because he's good. But I'm not, and it's something that, you know, he's good on, he's on it. Yeah, it's a very cool, very Batman quote. Very nice. Thank you, Leo, for doing that. I wish I could find it. Hopefully we'll have it for next week, or we'll find another one for next week, and we'll keep that cool and real cool, or he'll post it in the Twitch chat probably, and I'll find it. My favorite ones are twofold. One from an old, I believe, New Avengers comic from around 2005 or 2010, can't remember which one it was. And it's Wolverine in a meeting, and he's talking about, it's like, how are you on so many teams? And his quote is, "Multitasking, it's my secret mutant power." And obviously, I lived a little here. We don't have the exact quotes because we're still getting ready for cast, etc. But, you know, funny. Multitasking. Also, we talk about it. He's a loner, but he's on so many teams. So hilarious. And my other quote was, from one of the new Avengers ones, recently released on Marvel U. So this would have been a couple months ago, probably 6 or 7. And it's, I can't die without seeing the caviar vomiting robot eagle hovercraft. You might be able to, but I can't. I can't do it. Don't make me. It was a great line, man. Gotta love Hulkling and Wiccan. If you don't know Hulkling and Wiccan, they are some of the, not original, but they're some of the most recent gay comic book characters who are together. And they've got interesting stories. You'd have to check them out. I don't want to get too into depth there. Also, gotta keep forgetting, but opening up to hashtag Comicovnos, Comicovnos. Hit us up and let us know any questions or things you want us to say, etc. Or talk about for this show or others, and I'll address it at the end of this section. We're gonna go past our quotes into facts, which is a much funner one, much cooler one, much easier for us to recall and find. And I remember one that I've seen Leo post recently that I thought was a great one to include that I didn't get a chance to, was the... Leo has included the quote about Batman because he's a great writer, and he keeps track of his stuff. And the quote from Batman is, "If he wanted to, he could squish me into the cement, but Clark's got one weakness. Deep down, he's good. And deep down, I am not." It's a good Batman quote. Gotta stay Batman. Super Batman. Like how Batman's an adjective, and a verb, and a noun. Batman. Regardless, great quote. The quote... now, the fact that I was remembering from Leo's page was Spider-Man, and the quote is, or the fact is, the only reason Spider-Man is unworthy to lift Mjolnir is because he's unwilling to kill. Which is a cool thing, and it's very true. Spider-Man really is not willing to kill. It's one of his very big credos, very superhero, very PC from the age of no killing, no blood, no real violence. No violence! We're gonna beat the commies with love. Just kidding, I'm not super militant either. I just recognize force. We got more facts. This one I pulled from DC, and I want to put it in a picture because it's a great one from the new Rebirth series. Is even the Flash isn't fast enough to be in two places at once, but Godspeed is. Hey, that is a great fact. Thank you. Thank you, sir. I've been complimented by my partner in the podcast. Compliments are appreciated, sir. We keep up and we create music, and that's what we do, guys. Also, we'll mention a little bit more about that at the end. Hopefully get some links and tabs. And then another fact, and this one's one of my personal ones that I really enjoyed recently. I've even made a picture of. Hopefully it'll be on the Comicovnos page later. Is... Absorbing Man once swore loyalty to Thor after Odin died and he became the Allfather. And in this particular series, it got eventually retconned in continuity. Like, it wasn't retconned years later. It was literally retconned immediately because it was supposed to be an alternate future timeline thing. And basically, Odin dies and Thor becomes ruler of Asgard and he comes to Earth to fix Earth, kind of like Superman does in Injustice Gods Among Us, and it's a crazy-ass scene, but check it out, man. It's literally Absorbing Man basically kneeling at the feet of Thor. We've got the picture and everything. Oh, it's the craziest stuff. You don't even know. I think that's it for the facts. And we are down to our last social media section. Before we close out and do our saving info, etc., is our verses section. Both me and Leo have made some verses, and we've had good and bad experiences with both because of posting things, which is why hopefully our new page will be liked by many. You can post any comic stuff you want there. It'd be amazing. Leo's one, which is probably my favorite one, and the community loved it, got so many hits, so much, not a lot of discussion, I guess. It was very one-sided, even though it shouldn't have been. Was Cap versus Star-Lord. Great choices, honestly. I thought they were great matchup. A lot of people were very heavily picking on Cap, and that reflected heavily in the votes, not so much in the comments, which should be valued more. Obviously, you got to back it up with sources, comics, images. If you ain't got a picture in a comic, don't say my name. I will provide pictures. Comic books, people. Comic books. Scan if you have to. Find it online if you can. Do it. Don't be an uncredible jerk. Seriously. Don't talk out your ass. And do not use movies for the thing. That's the Marvel used cinematic universe, and we can discuss that if you'd like, but I refuse to intermingle with the comic universe. Two totally different universes. I'm telling you guys. I'm real adamant about this. I'm a nerd. Man. It should be great, though. Coming up near the end. And then the other verses, which... this one was also a little bit one-sided, but a little closer, I think, than the Cap and Star-Lord, and had no comments, was mine. And no one loves a villain, but I love to watch villains fight, and I want to know who'd win, so mine's are recently been villains. Red Skull versus Kingpin. And overwhelmingly, not overwhelmingly, but by a decent amount, Red Skull pulled ahead in this one. I think, I don't know if I'd put setup times or anything in this one, but I think it was a straight-up fight, and a lot of people went Red Skull, which is... fair to argue, but no one argued it. They just kind of went with him. Glad, you know, just check him out. We'll hopefully have those pictures up on Comicovnos by the end of tomorrow. Friday's going to be their day for kind of putting stuff up when we haven't had time on the cast or before the cast, etc. And please share stuff with us on the Comicovnos page. You know, let us know exactly what you think by tagging us at hashtag Comicovnos, C-O-M-I-C-N-V-O-S, Comicovnos. Sorry, I don't pronounce S's very well. Hit us up on Tumblr. Hit us up on Facebook at Comicovnos. Hashtag, or at Comicovnos, C-O-M-O, or C-O-M-I-C-C-O-N-V-O-S. Let us know some questions. Tell us episodes you want to read. Stuff like that. You know, let us know. Because then we can get your questions answered. I'm going to go look and see if we have any. Did you see they released a new Power Rangers? I did not see they released new Power Rangers. Are we discussing the movie? I'm unsure of, or another series of Power Rangers, as there's a dozen and a half of those. I know they were going to release new Power Rangers. I didn't know it had already released. It's good to know. Very recent. No, I had no clue. Actually, I had no idea that if there was a recent series. If the movie, yes, and I have seen the posters and Zord and Rita Repulsa. I didn't get to see the most recent ones, which I think they had Goldar or Golder. Well, it's so long since I've... The show's older than us, guys, or about as old as us. I mean, trying to remember all that stuff's tough. And I'm not sure. You know, I'd kind of know, but I did not see if they released a new one, and I'll have to check it out. I have not been watching a lot of new ones. I was unimpressed after Season 1 when I was a 3-year-old, and looking back, it wasn't that great either, but just classics, guys. Classics, you can't beat the classics. So before we run over, like, some of our links and thank yous and finishing off the show, I want to thank Leo for, you know, sending questions and hashtags and staying as both a viewer and a participator in the first week, even though he was sick. Everybody put a hand together for Leo. Seriously, it's a trooper. Hopefully he'll be here next week and we'll have, like, a legit discussion where I'm not just floundering by myself. Actually, I thought it didn't go so bad. It was very fun. You know, we covered a lot of the points, the main points, and hopefully new information stuff will surface next week. We can discuss some new stuff. And hopefully some of you guys will hit us with hashtags or questions, info, pictures, quotes, whatever, versus guys. For now, though, we're going to go over a little bit thing that I want to do now, which is kind of live, you know, comic merch, comics stuff, and just kind of a spotlight of live stuff that we've either purchased or seen or someone sent us, etc. Please send us stuff if you want to, wink wink, or pictures or stuff I can put on the stream. What I'm showing, this is Wolverine 32 from, I believe, this is the direct edition, but this is the second run of Wolverine. I cannot tell you the year because it's still in the plastic. Check this one out, guys. I'm serious. This is one about Wolverine in a Nazi concentration camp. And in this Nazi concentration camp, Wolverine basically just gets killed every day by this Nazi prison guard. This is supposed to be pre-Weapon X, I assume. Because they gas him and burn him, do all kinds of crazy shit to him. But But it keeps coming back, and eventually this guy goes crazy, kills himself, basically, or dies, whatever. But it's the whole thing is, though, we weren't trapped in Auschwitz with him. He wasn't trapped in there with us. We were trapped in there with him. Wolverine. And that whole series is actually great if you haven't seen that run of Wolverine, which I believe is the second run of that title. And I believe is like 2007, 2010. I put everything about that date. I'm bad with dates and numbers and names and names and numbers. Last thing. Also, thank you to Leo for taking us out and buying stuff last week. And so shout out to Leo. Hopefully you guys buy some stuff and mention the blurred, my friend, and his podcast. But he's encouraged me to get my collection started on my Pops and my Funkos, and I got Slapstick. It looks like Deadpool, but it's Slapstick as Deadpool as seen in the merch for money. Man, these things are fucking accurate. I wish I could have got Madcap, but they were fucking sold out. Thank you guys for watching the first episode. Please check out The Blurred. Please check out Comicovnos. Check out Axel Grave on SoundCloud, YouTube, and Twitter. Check us out Facebook, Tumblr. You can check us out all over for sound music.